are lonely, it didn't mean that you are a loser. It means that it can mean that you are an independent, strong woman with high self-value. And those who think that you are a loser, it means that they don't have high standards. Their self-value is lower than yours. For example, you have apples and you must choose from rotten apples, apple who is less rotten. Oh, you have just, but you're looking for the apple who is not rotten. And someone say, oh, you have too high standards. You never, in this way, you will never found normal, healthy apple who is not rotten. So the same is also with people. Why I must choose from rotten people, someone who is less rotten, or found someone who is not rotten when everybody is rotten. Oh, you have too much high standards. No. Oh, it's raining. So if you have yourself value, so you value yourself in a high standard, and you can find the partner, because you see around the people, the partner whom you can choose, they have lower self-value. So it didn't mean that you are a loser. It means that your self-value is in a high level. It's the same like I won't find perfect apple which is healthy, but I must choose from rotten apple the apple who is less rotten. But I want apple who is not rotten. Oh, you have too much high standards. You never found healthy good apple with such a altitude. No, this is the same with people. I never lower your self value to fit this person who is lower. So you must put yourself lower. We have amazing weather today. So if I want, so I have person who self-value is lower, and if I want to be with this person, I must then put my self-value down to be in his level, which is down. So this is wrong. If you are yourself, if you are in a high level, you don't need to put yourself. It's like it's not progress, it's regress. It's you're instead of growing, you're going back. So you need partner who is spirituality, physically, in all aspects, in your level. Enough in your level that you are okay with this person and you are happy with this person. Those women who are single, lonely very long time, they are 30 years, you're still not married, no children, or you're lucid. No, this is wrong. Of course, there is maybe some exceptions, but it can be also that those women are strong, independent, intelligent, and they have very high self-value. So they are looking for the person, for partner, who are in the same level as she. She has her own value standards. So why she must lower her value, personal value standards as woman to fit with this, for example, with this man who value standards, family values, life values, everything is much, much lower to be with him. It's absolutely wrong. You don't go to progress, but you regress in yourself for this person. Actually, in the end, will not treat you in the right way and will not respect you. So this is wrong. Never put your self-value lower to be this person who don't respect you. And if he is not in this level already, he will never become in your level. You can just take someone who is much lower level than you and think that you can make him to be in your level. It will never happen. It will be misunderstanding and fights. He will never understand that. So you better stay single, be patient, and wait for the right person for you. No matter if you're 30 years, I'm so what for your 40 years old or 45. You know, you better be alone and happy without stress than be with someone with who you feel angry, not happy, disappointed, stressed. You just waste your happiness. You waste your time. So better stay single and think about yourself. Take care about yourself, educate yourself, become more high level, and you will then attract the men of your level. When you stop paying attention to those people who are not in your level, they just want to destroy you, take you from up to down on their level. So yeah, that's it. That's how it is. When you start dating a person and you see the first red flags, pay attention on them. Don't close eyes on those red flags. It will not get better. It will not get better. More far you will go, much more you will want to know better this person with red flags. The more red flags you'll be, and more disappointed you will be. In the first week, maybe first month, you see there is one red flag, another one red flag. Again, you don't feel good about what he say, how he treat you. Just close the doors for this person forever. You see, you know, when you see the first red flag, oh, let's see what will be for. Maybe it's just nothing. No, it's not nothing. It's just a first warning for you. For example, you like this and this. You have standards and family values on this. And he saying opposite. Oh, I don't care about this. I don't care that everything. What I interesting is what is most important when two people love each other. But everything else, it's no matter for me. But anybody can say, oh, I love you, I hate you, I abusing you, but because I love you, so this is, go to someone else, meet someone else. Again, red flag, close the door. Don't worry if you are alone, you stay again single, you're 30 years, again single. But it's better than you find the perfect person for your life and spend quality time together than found this rotten person and spend unqualitative time with this person, dealing with his jealousy, abuse, some strange comments with low family values, and absolutely don't understanding about what is family values. You can find happiness also being alone, and your partner is not key for your happiness, for your balance and harmony in your life. You first of all must find balance and happiness inside you, with yourself.